Captain says, I'm sorry, but since you heard us talking, I can't let you go. Chris says, we didn't hear anything. We didn't hear anything about troops coming from Castle Rudo. Chris! Badat calls her an idiot. Oh my, nice. Yurio says, she always talks a little too much. It's none of your business, says Chris. Captain says, I'll decide to do what to do with them later. Put them in prison for now. Prison again? That's exactly what I was about to say, Chris says. Xella says, it's my first time. Not wanting to fight the soldiers, they were put in the prison at the Fothia border. Huh, now we're in that big cell. Well, that's for four of us. All the solitary cells are occupied, so you must stay in a common cell. Don't fight with your cellmate. Yurio says, I don't see anyone beside us. But there is someone. There's a strange man called the Prison Lord. He's always taking a nap behind the barrels. He seems to like that place a lot. Oh yeah, I see his feet over there. Just don't talk to him. It's for your own safety. Sorry, but I must put you in here with him. We're definitely going to talk to him. Chris says, what's a prison lord? Badat says, a person who's been in prison for a long time and gained some power of the soldiers. Even the soldiers respect the prison lord. That usually means he's a great villain who committed heinous crimes. We are so unlucky, says Yurio. Let's check him out. Chris says to him, are you okay? Don't worry, says Yurio. The soldier was right. I see legs behind the barrels. A man snore, him mumbling. He's sleeping, says Yurio. What did you see, says Chris. He's sleeping. What did he look like? I only saw his legs. Right. Badat says, he must have some nerves of steel to be sleeping so calmly in a prison cell. But what else is there to do? We should stay away from him. I agree, says Stella. Yurio says, let's stay on this side and avoid being spoken to. Good idea, says Badat. So, what should we do now? Well... Chris says, first we must get out of here. Stella says, but even if we were able to escape, they would catch us right away if the bridges were not connected. Yurio says, the bridges connect at the scheduled times, right? Yeah, says Badat. The soldier said so. Chris says, does anyone know the schedule? Stella says, if we know when the bridges are connected, I can use my bombs around that time as a smoke screen to help us escape. So you didn't confiscate our weapons. That's real smart of them. Badat says, no, that's not a good idea. We don't know the situation on the other side of the bridge. What if there are hundreds of soldiers on the other side? If we do too much damage here, they'll give us a hard time on the other side of the bridge. You have a point, says Yurio. Chris says, by the way, we need to know when the bridges connect. Yeah, back to that. Yeah, says Yurio. Hey, can't we see the bridge from the window? Badat says, if the bridges are up, I think we can see them from the window. Should we go and take a look? As you guys talk so much, just walk over to the window. But the window is near the prison, Lord. Well, look out the other window. Don't worry, Badat says, he's asleep. Remember to tiptoe. Go, go. Don't push me, Yurio says. I'm the one who's taking the risk. You said it first, so of course you should do it yourself. All right. He's mumbling. Yurio goes, eep. I think he's awake. Badat says, you don't have to come back and report to us. I slept very well. It was indeed a pleasant sleep. He seems to be in a good mood, says Yurio. Chris says, we don't know that yet. Woo! He's moving, says Yurio. Chris says, shh. Sounds of moving. The man is moving. Yurio says, he's doing something. You're not getting it on back there, are you? Badat says, ignore him. Now it's quiet, says Yurio. Has he gone back to sleep again? Stella asks. Chris says, I think so. I see his legs. Here comes the guard. Hey! Don't be alarmed. He won't come attacking you for no reason. He's just a little eccentric. Thanks for that? A little eccentric, Chris says. That's a characteristic of a dangerous person. She's right, says Yurio. But Yurio, an eccentric man in barrels. Yurio says, they remind me of Uncle Huck. Who is Uncle Huck, says Badat. It's Chris's uncle. The last time we saw him, he suddenly appeared from behind some barrels. He's very eccentric. So he just happens to find barrels wherever he goes? You don't have to use very, says Chris. Really? So you have a strange relative. Anyway, Yurio, go take a look one more time. This time check his face, too. Me again? We'll be nervous if we don't know who he is. We can't even plan our escape. You're right, but... Don't worry, says Chris. If something happens to you, we will do whatever it takes to help you. What is gonna happen to me? Nothing. Just go. Alright. Chris says, what is it? He's gone, says Yurio. He's not gone, I still see his legs. Chris says, but we see his legs right there. But I can't find him. What's that supposed to mean? Badat says, let me see. Ah, it is Uncle Huck, who goes, ack! This is great! Great indeed. What an inevitable twist of fate. Yurio goes, ha, huh. Uncle Huck, says Chris. Hello. Why are you here? Yurio says, yeah, don't hello us. Explain. Badat says, is he really Chris's uncle? I think so, says Stella. Why are you in this prison? Asks Chris. Did you do something wrong? Says Yurio. Hold your horses. Just calm down. You may have many questions, before I explain what happened, I must ask you a favor, Yurio. Yes? Yurio, please give me the pair of trousers over there. These trousers and shoes? That's right. You know why I left my trousers and shoes near the barrels? I know you're curious. Badat says, not really. Don't lie to me. Alright, if you insist. Badat says, hey. As long as they see the legs sticking out from the barrels, the soldiers will think I'm sleeping behind them. But in reality, I was digging a tunnel. I call it the decoy legs operation. Pretty good plan, isn't it? Yurio says, you haven't changed a bit. Here, your trousers and shoes. Yurio handed the trousers and shoes to Huck. Excuse me, give me a moment to put on my trousers. Hello. Yurio, Chris, you look well. We're like reintroducing ourselves again. You must be their traveling companions. My name is Huck. I'm Chris's uncle. Pleased to meet you. Now that I properly introduced myself, why don't we sit down at the table over there and talk? Sit down. Uncle Huck. Yurio says, but you only have one chair. Oh, that's right. I'm so sorry. I've been here alone too long. Feel free to sit on the floor. He's certainly eccentric, says Badat. Yurio and the company sat around the table and asked why Huck was in prison. Uncle Huck, why are you in this prison? I didn't do anything wrong. It's what I call a twist of fate. It happened in Menarth as withered leaves fell. Uncle? Yes? This thing in Menarth, does it have a direct connection with why you are in prison? Not at all. I knew it. Chris, you've become much sharper since the last time we met. Have I? Yurio says, then why are you here, Uncle Huck? Well, it was after the Hawk Talon arrived in Menarth and I parted from you. I began walking down the street and suddenly I remembered I forgot something. Forgot something? Says Chris. My notebook recording my findings about the Moonlight Witch. Without the notebook, I can't do my research effectively. I had no choice but to return to Neri. I boarded the Hawk Talon for free and went back to Raguna. Chris says, you should pay once in a while. Don't worry, Captain Jilba gave me a free pass. Everything went smoothly until I got home. Unfortunately, I was caught by the loan shark. While I was running away from him, the last liner for the year departed. They didn't wait for me. So cruel. Nerio says, it's almost drift ice season. So I gave up on traveling east and headed west, passing through the Radera Gate and taking the road to the capital. Chris says, we understand you traveled west, but why on earth did you put you here? They didn't put me here. It may look that way, but everything is part of a plan. A plan, says Yurio. I was waiting here for Chris and Yurio. Waiting for us, says Chris? That's right. You had to pass this checkpoint to get home, so I knew I would see you if I waited here. I can stay here free, and they give me meals too. It's a nice long-term lodging. The loan shark in Raguna put me on his debtors list, so I have no trouble checking in. Ha ha ha. These guys are really confused here. So what brought you here? Chris says, we overheard some soldiers' conversation. Badat says, it was something we shouldn't have heard. What is it? Yorio says, if you know, they'll put you in prison too. He's already in prison. I'm already in prison, says Chris, but I think it's supposed to be Huck saying that. Oh, that's right. Then it shouldn't be a problem, haha. Huck laughs too. They were talking about more troops calling from Castle Rude. Was it Rudo? By the way, Uncle Huck, why were you waiting for us? Oh yes, I traveled many places in search of the legend of the Moonlight Witch. I stumbled across an important clue about her whereabouts in Aroza, just west of here. An important clue, says Badat. Chris says, Uncle Huck is researching the Moonlight Witch. I see. So what is this important clue? It's interesting. The Moonlight Witch traveled throughout Tirasweel and came back to Foltheon. Yurio says she was heading for Castle Rude. What? How did you know? It's a hunch. Okay, then did you know this? In Aroza, there was a granddaughter of a former court swordsman of Castle Rude. She told me that her grandfather was very close to the Moonlight Witch. Chris says, is this court swordsman Durazel? What? How do you know so much? The great oracle of Oldos told us to see him. Yeah, says Yurio. He is now trapped in a place called Darufez. You know everything already. This is no fun. During our pilgrimage, we heard many stories about the Moonlight Witch. Chris says, we also heard some in Fenthi and Gadonal while we were on our way back from Oldos. Yurio and Chris described all the encounters that involved information about the Moonlight Witch. Huck listened to their stories with wide eyes, taking notes here and there. Yurio and Chris thought it was a good opportunity to tell Huck, Stella, and Badat about the Wave of Ryual. So they told them everything the Great Oracle said at the shrine in Oldos. It took quite a while for them to explain everything. Yeah, it's quite a reveal there. I didn't know, says Huck. Stella says, the Wave of Ryual. Amazing, says Badat. The story is too deep for me to grasp. Huck says, You had a fruitful journey. You learned more details than I did through my research. Badat says, you can't beat these two, Huck. Don't be discouraged. Discouraged? Me? Ha ha ha. No way. I have a scoop. A scoop, says Stella. That's why I was waiting for you here. But this is serious. Huck suddenly put on a serious face. The girl in Aroza, her name is Joanna. She heard one of the Moonlight Witch's prophecies from Durzel. It was her last prophecy. Chris says, the Moonlight Witch's final prophecy? Right. After that, there are no more legends telling of the Moonlight Witch. Nobody knows whether she is alive or dead. But I'm pretty sure what Durzel heard was her last prophecy. It says, when emotionless soldiers pass the borders, The king bound by a spell will lose his power. Oceans and mountains will all die. Emotionless soldiers. Well, these soldiers have emotions, right? They're all angry. So we gotta make sure they stay angry. The wave of evil will be drawn by a woman from another world and a man who manipulates stars. Huh. A woman from another world and a man who manipulates stars. Oh! What's his name? He's trying to use a telescope or some kind of thing. Not even a telescope, but something. Some kind of astronomy related device in the castle. So he's the man who manipulates stars. I think that's Revas. The woman from another world. I don't know if that's referring to the Moonlight Witch. Or who that is. The wave of evil, says Stella. That's the wave of Rayuol. Chris says, what about a woman from another world? No other prophecy mentioned her. Chris Yurio says, yeah, the Moonlight Witch must have found out about her in Fothia. A man who manipulates stars must be referring to Revas. Correct. Badat says, the king, of course, is King Rudolph at Castle Rudo. Now they call it Rudo again. Huck says, I guess emotionless soldiers in her last prophecy refers to the troops that you heard were heading here. If we don't do anything, the arrival of the wave of Rayuol will become a certainty. We mustn't waste time. Yuyo, you have the silver dagger, right? Of course. But why? Joanna and Aroza mentioned something to me. Before Durzo was locked up in Derufez, he often said something interesting to her? What? He said, I wish there were pilgrims with the silver dagger traveling through the five shrines according to the ancient custom. That's us, says Chris. Yeah, says Yurio, we meet the condition. Right, that's why I was waiting for you. Stella says, you are also waiting for the emotionless soldiers here so you can confirm the prophecy, right? Right. Uncle Huck, are you really a genius? Ahem. Things will become clearer once we talk to Master Durzal. I have a feeling that the silver dagger is the key that connects the five shrines, the Moonlight Witch, and the Wave of Rayuol. As you know, our coming-of-age pilgrimage is based on the old pilgrimage that witches and sorcerers used to do. Many villages had this custom before, but now only a handful retain the tradition. Of course, it is natural that the customs and lifestyles of people change with time. But think, who started the pilgrimage, and for what reason? Why did they give us the silver dagger? Even now, no one can explain the existence of the shrines and spells. Stella says, her last prophecy mentioned a woman from another world. That's the key point. Maybe these mysteries cannot be explained by what we know about this world. They may have something to do with another world, too. That's the conclusion I reached. Great Oracle Denkin told you that only a person who is connected to another world can know about the Wave of Rayuol, right? Yes, says Chris. Anyway, we must go to Aroza. You have completed your pilgrimage. If I bring you to Joanna, we may be able to obtain new information. Then we should head for Derufez and see Master Durzal. If the events mentioned in the last prophecy are already happening, we don't have much time left. By the way, says Badat, I heard a rumor that Durzal is a legendary swordmaster. He was also very loyal to the king and an exemplary swordsman. Well, that would be the swordmaster part. You know about Durzal too, says Chris. Yurio says Lodi also mentioned him. Lodi? Says Badat. Chris says, a swordsman we traveled together for a while. He also said Durzal was the only great swordsman he respected. See? Says Badat. It's strange. Why is a person like that locked up? Something is wrong, says Yurio. Chris says, Uncle, how are we going to escape from here? Are we going to use tunnel? Are we going to use tunnel? Don't worry. I dug this hole specifically for this day, based on my accurate measurements. It should open near the bridge. I left only a thin layer of soil at the other end. We can break through easily. Hopefully whoever, like, guard doesn't just walk across that patch, because he'll fall through and then discover it. Badat says, the only problem is that we don't know when the bridges will be connected. We may be able to get out of here, but without the bridge, we can't cross over to the other side. You don't need to worry about that either. According to my stomach, a soldier will come to check on us soon. He comes at the same time as when the bridges connect. Don't worry, if we go through the tunnel, we can get there quickly. We can even leave after the bridges are connected. See? The soldier is here. According to his stomach. So, when he gets hungry? And the soldier's talking to one of the other prisoners, asking, is everything okay? Aof says, the moles are quiet today. Are you still talking about the moles? There is no way we have such huge moles. Hey, you guys. I'm sorry. Have you been forced to listen to Huck's story? He's quiet when he's asleep, but once he starts talking, he just won't stop. He's been giving us a hard time, too. Huck, take it easy on the rookies, will you? Huck says, why don't you join us, too? I just started an interesting story. No thanks. Maybe some other time. You enjoy. Wow, this is a long cutscene. There's the bridge. Huck says, okay now. Follow me. Let's go. Yurio says, are we going to be okay? Yurio, we don't have time, Chris says. Alright. Here's your moles. Hey, I hear moles moving. I knew there were moles. But why haven't others heard them? Am I cursed by moles or something? It's scary. I should keep quiet. Oh. Huck says, was it this way? Well, you're the one who dug the tunnel. You made a branching tunnel? Yurio says, you're not sure? Didn't you measure accurately, says Chris? It was accurate when I dug. It's just I got carried away and dug extra tunnels. Which one is the real escape tunnel? Don't ask me, says Yurio. Why don't you dig a little, says Chris. Huck dug some dirt. I don't think this is the way. This guy... Look what's the marks above his head. Does it mean he can hear them? Chris says, are you sure this time? Probably. Wait, says Yurio. Where are Badat and Stella? Badat says, we're fine. Stella says, don't worry. Okay. We got horses. Uncle Huck, are we there yet? Almost. We should be very close to the bridge. Are you sure? Says Yurio. It feels like we've walked forever. They're walking down there? I figured they're crawling. Nope. Huck says, oh, I'm sorry. I went a little too far west. We don't have time for this, says Chris. The bridges will go up again. Sink or swim, Badat says. Go out here and run for the bridge. Stella says, if they come after us, I'll use my bombs. Yurio says, wow, big dogs. To the horses. Well, we're near the bridge because I can see up the upper left-hand corner, water. Chris says, look carefully. They're horses. Horses. Yurio, stop messing around. Huck says, how can soldiers be there? We're in trouble. Should I use my bomb? Says Stella. No. These soldiers don't seem to be the ones mentioned in the prophecy. We don't want to hurt them. The captain still gives things over his head. Come this way, says Huck. Let's ride the horses away. I'll jump over a soldier with this horse. While the soldiers are in a state of confusion, you guys cross the bridge. Got it? I didn't know you were good at horseback riding, Uncle. I'm a wandering scholar who dedicates his life to the study of the Moonlight Witch. I can control a horse or two, even in my sleep. It's like Yurio, who can get to his bed half asleep. What? Yurio says nothing. Let's go. Well, get on it. Things didn't go as I planned. Hurry, says Yurio. The bridge will start rising. I haven't ridden a horse lately. Maybe I should take that one. I'll jump on him from behind. Oh my god! Well, that worked. The soldier says, what was that? Well, time to make a break for it. Stella has an idea. Now! Bye, Captain. Uncle Hawk. Bad-Ad says, leave it to me. You cross the bridge. Yo-Yo says, okay. Oh, crap. Hawk says, oh no. Bad-Ad says, we must jump. They missed. We couldn't make it, Hawk says. Can you climb? We will see you later, says Bad-Ad. Don't worry. Yo-Yo, take this, says Hawk. What's that? We'll catch you later, so don't worry about us. Alright, says Yo-Yo. Promise. Bad-Ad says, yeah. Hawk says, hurry, go on. The soldier says, they're unbelievable. Chris asks, are they gonna be alright? Yo-Yo says, we're talking about Uncle Hawk and Bad-Ad. They should be fine. Stella says, so we should head for Aroza. We must first see Joanna. Alright, we need that book. Yo-Yo and his company organized a party. Don't forget to bring this, Yo-Yo says. Yo-Yo and his company obtained Huck's notes. I want to read them. Is it under books? Various findings on the Moonlight Witch and some confessions by Hawk. Okay, the Moonlight Witch. Oh wow. Menarth. When the Earth forgets to produce, a mountain will cross the sea and the people will cry out in despair. The Moonlight Witch who came to the shrine in Tagura left these words 20 years ago. Reportedly, the Moonlight Witch also told the locals about the peat mines in the Tagura Caverns. Because of peat, the island people found another source of income other than fishery. Some people in Menarth blame the poor crops on a witch's spell. However, witches are appreciated on the Negara Island, also in Menarth, because the witch told them how to exploit peat mines. It's a mystery. The same prophecy is also left in Nelva. Does it refer to the same event? Another prophecy is found in Nelva. An evil mountain will appear from the sea and leave the town in ruins. These words of the Moonlight Witch are also found in Ambush. An old lady in Tayuyal told me the name of the Moonlight Witch. Her name is Gweld. The name is filled with great sadness. Chenom? There was a poisonous swamp in a deserted village near Dice. Rumor has it that the swamp was created by a spell cast by the Moonlight Witch. Is the Moonlight Witch evil? No. An old lady in the slam remembered about Gweld. She was about 18 then. If so, she must be 38 now. I really want to see her. Ambush? Magisa, the canned master, met Gweld when she was 5. Gweld taught her the correct way to use spells, how to treat others, and how to interpret and respond to prophecies. It is said that Gweld was better at chapel spells than canned spells. There was a book in Ambush that talks about the Moonlight Witch. I think I read it. Udor? I haven't been able to find any messages from the Moonlight Witch in Udor. However, Udor has a shrine in Shifuul. She must have left some words there. Addition, I obtained information in Shifuul. In Forest of No Return, treetops sway as they receive winds from Shifuul. The Moonlight Witch reportedly said this in Shifuul. This is all very interesting. Aldos. The Moonlight Witch doesn't seem to have left any prophecies in Aldos. Further research required. Alright, we got three more. Fenty? In Fenty, records tell of a traveling witch who I believe is the Moonlight Witch. On the shores of Lake Rupinas is... It's bothersome, but I'll write down the entire text. I should read this again. Fenty, which lies along the shores of Lake Lupinas, is divided into two areas, the north and the south. This is Lupinas. The north is governed by King Enaton, while the south is ruled by his younger brother Kalak. Originally, Hazen in the north was the only capital, but the king divided the country at the births of his twin princes. A mansion was built in Heruku. The king wished that the two princes would build a new nation. Perhaps out of grief over this event, a traveling witch left these words. Mother divides blood not to divide a country. It seems she is sounding an alarm for the future of Fenty. Godona? I haven't checked out Godona yet. Further research required. Fothia. The words of Dirzal, as told by Joanne. When emotionless soldiers pass the borders, the king bound by the spell will lose his power. Oceans and mountains will all die. The wave of evil will be drawn by a woman from another world and a man who manipulates stars. What an ominous prophecy. Is this the final prophecy left by the Moonlight Witch Gweld? Further research required. Okay, Land of the Witches. There are at least three names of places having witch in them. They are Witch's Sea, Witch's Island, and Witch's Stepping Stone. Witch's Sea, the inland sea facing the coastlines of Fothia, Menarth, Chenom, Udor, and Godona. Many of the myths relating to witches were born around this inland sea, hence its name. Witch's Island, it is said that a mysterious island exists somewhere in the Witch's Sea. Only Ortega, who built Aldos, has safely returned from Witch's Island. Why, that's the dragon slayer guy. Witch's Stepping Stone. The middle island by the Bridge of Three Capitals is called the Witch's Stepping Stone. Its name originated from the anecdote that the witches crossed from Chenom to Ambish, using this island as a stepping stone before the bridge was built. Okay. The Crimson Fire Gems. I remember them. These gemstones only found on Negar Island in Menarth. Crimson Fire Gems are made by cultivating pearl oysters in the peat swamp deep in the Tagura Mines. The Moonlight Witch may have taught the locals how to make Crimson Fire Gems. Many are enthralled by the expensive gems, however, overgrown crimson fires can explode. A story says that the secret of its beauty lies in the spiritual catharsis the jewel induces in people who see it. And miscellaneous notes. Other random note. I write down my conscience here. If you find this notebook, please don't read it, but return it to me. Oh well. In our defense, he gave it to us, and we didn't actually find it, quote-unquote. Loan ledger. Gotch, 5,000 piers. Dotch, 3,400 piers. Atch, 4,600 piers. I intend to return the money, so you shouldn't feel guilty. Yep, good idea. Alright, that's that. Who's that? Lang, the bridge guard. You came across the bridges? That's pretty rare these days. We haven't had any travelers passing through here lately. Until the troops from Castle Rudo arrive, people are staying away from the border. I feel lonely guarding the bridge. Thank you. more peoples. Nothing here, right, that I can't see? Oh, we're sliding on over here. Hi, did you come from Godona? That's strange. I didn't think anyone would be passing by here. Yuria says, we're on our way back from our pilgrimage to Aldos. Oh, so you're from Folthia. Welcome back. Yuria showed him the silver dagger. Check. Okay, you can go. Thank you, says Yuria. Good thing he didn't know about what the soldiers on the other side are up to. Chris says, can I ask you something, soldier? Yes? People on the south side of the bridge look agitated. But I see fewer soldiers on this side, and you guys seem relaxed. Oh, that. The soldiers on the south side were drafted from various places only a short time ago. They've just finished extending the border infrastructure. And now elite troops are being sent from the castle to take their place. I understand how they feel. They have no choice, though. It's an order from the castle. We're just taking it easy on this side. Just between you and me, I think something's going to happen at this border. You better go back to your hometown. Wow. This just goes back around. Yo-Yo says, ah. Oh boy. That's a lot of soldiers. Soldier leader says, we'll stay at this border until further instructions. Everyone, get in the barracks. I like the song. Yo-Yo says, they've finally arrived. Let's peek from the window, says Chris. What if we go this way instead? See what's down here. What if we go in instead? Hey, I thought you were gone. Go home quickly. Did you see their faces? They were like clay dolls, having no emotion at all. It's eerie. These guys could be very dangerous. Don't hang around and go straight home. Well, we're hanging around. Stella says, they don't look alive. Right, says Yuria. Chris says, they have no emotion, just as the prophecy said. I guess we're leaving. Go that way. That's a dead end. Alright guys, stay tuned for the next episode when we continue going towards Castle Rudo. We are here. We need to go to Darufez next. It's over that way. So thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.